For Attorney General, we go to Jeff Sessions from, I believe, Alabama. It looks like he's going to be our Attorney General. The Senate has been very kind to him because he's a senator. They tend to take care of their own. Has he been a friend of Exxon Mobil?
He has. He's been really a longtime friend of Exxon Mobil. Also has, as a senator, has gotten many political contributions from Exxon, up to, I think, $10,000 from ExxonMobil, and then even more when you count kind of the entire oil and gas industry at large. And similar to Scott Pruitt, he's also written letters in support of ExxonMobil. This is specifically in relation to the investigations going on by the state attorney generals in Massachusetts and New York, the investigation that we discussed earlier. And he wrote a letter to the Department of Justice, which it looks like he'll be running soon, asking them to basically quash any investigation into Exxon on their knowledge of climate, the risks of climate change.
Which would just be a windfall for ExxonMobil to their bottom line. It would be like saying, when the state attorney generals were ganging up on the tobacco industry a couple decades ago, and there was this amazing settlement that supposedly went to states to help with health care, to pay damages for cigarettes. It would be the equivalent of an attorney general and a Justice Department trying to stop the tobacco companies from being sued by state attorney generals for hiding the evidence that they were manipulating nicotine levels and that they knew cigarettes were cancerous before the public did.
Exactly.
Yeah, this is...
And that's,
go ahead.
I was just going to say, and there's a lot of parallels between this investigation and the settlement reached with the tobacco industry about, you know, just kind of fundamentally misleading the public about the harms of its products, carbon pollution being for ExxonMobil. Another thing that recent settlement that we compare this to is the Volkswagen case where they were polluting and cheating the system basically on their pollution. And they just settled for $14.7 billion. And that was for lying about polluting over 7 years. And so if you kind of multiply that by the 40 years that Exxon has allegedly lied about the knowledge of climate change, then that's a pretty hefty sum for them.
You're listening to Highlights from the David Feldman Show, heard nationwide on Pacifica Radio, or as a podcast on iTunes, Stitcher, and now YouTube. Please subscribe to this channel. For more information, go to davidfeldmanshow.com. Thank you for listening.
The David Feldman Radio program is made possible by listeners like you. You sad, pathetic humps.